challenging and treacherous. Historically understudied. Geographically remote. At the bottom of the planet lies the sprawling Southern Ocean, a body of water critical to our understanding of global climate, and yet still a mystery. Until now. Thanks to a six-year, $22 million grant from the National Science Foundation, with additional support from NASA and NOAA, a team of researchers came together to form the Southern Ocean Carbon and Climate Observations and Modeling Project, more commonly known as SOCCOM. The goal? Gain a better scientific understanding of the waters that encircle Antarctica with data gathered from a fleet of robotic floats.
We went into this program with the idea that the Southern Ocean absorbs 40% of the carbon dioxide that humankind emits to the atmosphere. Maybe that's completely wrong. Maybe it's something closer to 0%.
Our biggest surprise was that the southern side of this huge current, it's called the Antarctic Circumpolar Current, the south side of that is gassing carbon out into the atmosphere. And the amount is larger than anybody expected.
A game-changing discovery with far-reaching implications for how climate change, driven largely by human activities on land, is impacting our ocean. Long believed to be a massive carbon sink, the Southern Ocean actually emits a great deal of carbon dioxide through outgassing. That happens when very slow-moving currents gradually transport carbon from decayed microorganisms stored in cold, deep waters to the surface of the Southern Ocean, burping out CO2.
I mean, we saw a lot of carbon down there coming out of the surface.
How were the scientists able to see this? Through massive amounts of data sent back continuously by 200 robotic floats, some adopted, named, and tracked by students around the world and placed throughout the Southern Ocean. These floats came equipped with sensors that made it possible to measure not only the salinity and temperature of the ocean, but also factors linked to biology, like pH, oxygen, nutrients, and chlorophyll. The floats gathered all this information from all parts of the Southern Ocean, at all times of the year, and in all kinds of conditions, something not possible by scientists on boats, especially in the winter when weather makes ship operations potentially hazardous.
Who goes there in the winter? You can't. It's covered with sea ice. It's dark, it's windy, it's horrible. You put the floats in and off they go. We have information for a bunch of years now with each of those floats making these measurements every 10 days. And it really is transformational. It has completely changed what we know about the Southern Ocean.
And we now have 6 years of data. That's the baseline. We don't know, you know, what it was like 20 years ago. We just know we have now have a baseline for the current, you know, half decade that these have been running. And we're gonna, if we wanna know about change, we're gonna have to keep this going for decades more to see, you know, is the ocean healthy?
And now the scientists hope the SOCCOM model will be used to check the health of the global ocean.
That's our next step. We're at this phase of having this SOCCOM project, which we think of as solving a lot of problems for the Southern Ocean, now is considered to be a massive pilot project for a global array.
And we're gonna transform the way that scientists work on climate issues, both from the observations and the modeling, from the chemistry to the physics.
And the enduring success of SOCCOM can be measured in ways that aren't just quantitative.
We're building a community that's far bigger than we had ever imagined.
We have proved to the world how to work collegially, collaboratively, transparently, and inclusively across disciplines in a major project.
So we've trained, you know, many students, and they can take over from us. They're our legacy.
A new generation of scientists to unlock the countless mysteries that the ocean still holds.